so you can ollie while standing still and manage to ollie while moving too. But as soon as you try to ollie over something, all of a sudden something goes off and everything becomes harder. But why? Let's scientifically break it down. In this video, I will explain some important points of an ollie over an obstacle: speed, line of sight, center of gravity, and the use of the front foot. You're watching Why the Trek, please subscribe. First, let's consider the most obvious difference between a stationary ollie and a moving ollie: speed. In order to understand exactly how fast you need to roll to get over an obstacle, let's do a simple math assuming you are jumping over lying on the ground. Imagine you are approaching straight into the line. The required travel distance of an ollie becomes the shortest when you pop right before the front wheels touch the line, and the rear wheels land just across the line. This distance is practically equal to the length of the wheelbase, which in my case is 45 cm. Assuming your ollie is 15 cm high, the duration you stay in the air equals the length of an object to free fall 15 cm upward and then come back down again. According to my calculation, it is approximately 0.35 seconds. As speed is obtained by distance divided by time, 45 cm divided by 0.35 seconds is around 1.29 meters per second. Well, how fast is it? The length of a skateboard deck is about 80 cm, which means rolling at 1.29 meters per second is more or less rolling at the speed of around 1.5 decks per second. And this is how it should look when simulated with a 3D model. Slow enough, isn't it? Of course, how fast you should roll depends on how high you ollie. If you ollie 30 cm high, for example, you can stay in the air for 0.495 seconds and rolling at the speed of 0.91 meters per second to get you over the line. When your ollie reaches as high as 60 cm, the air time becomes around 0.7 seconds and the required velocity becomes 0.64 meters per second, shorter than the length of a deck. In other words, the higher you ollie, the slower you can roll. But obviously, it is hard to ollie so high at the beginning. So let's assume your ollie is 15 cm high. In this case, you need to be able to ollie at the speed of 1.5 decks per second. If not, at least mathematically speaking, you're not yet ready to ollie over things. Don't be discouraged though, there are plenty of things you can try without an ollie. For example, curving and cruising always feels good, a bunny hop and windy bunny hops. I just realized I can hand slide with a wrist guard, and ghost flips if you wish. Find a way to improve while having fun. Next, now that you know how fast you need to roll, let's see how to do it. The first is the line of sight, which greatly affects the timing of the trek. Keep your eyes on the obstacle until you reach right in front of it. Then, when sliding up your front foot, shift it to the nose or your front foot if necessary. As the obstacle gets closer, the nose blocks your sight and the obstacle goes behind the nose. However, do not rush to pop while the obstacle is visible. For example, when a man who's 170 cm tall is standing on a skateboard, there is usually a blind spot of around 20 cm from the nearest visible point on the ground to the front wheels. Originally, the distance you needed to ollie was 45 cm, but by popping too early, you will need to jump another 20 cm, which is 1.5 times greater than the original distance, unnecessarily increasing the difficulty. To solve this problem, understanding the locations of the front wheels is essential. Try bumping the front wheels against the obstacle you are trying to ollie over, so you can grasp their actual locations without having to see them. The next vital factor is the position of the center of gravity. Your body axis tends to lean forward, as it is natural to lean in a direction that you're looking at, which in this case is the obstacle. The further your body axis tilts forward, the more energy of the pop disperses backward. In addition, because a skateboard naturally moves back and forth, your back foot will shift even farther in the opposite direction of travel by the time the tail reaches the ground. If you pop in this state, you won't be able to generate an effective upward force to lift your body. Since gravity pulls your body weight straight downward, the force of the pop needs to be applied in the opposite direction, vertically upward. If you want to analyze your movement effectively, try YTRX chart analyzer. By uploading a video, the system will automatically visualize your motion on a graph. There's a link in the description, so be sure to check it out. Finally, let's see the use of the front foot. A common mistake people make is to push their front feet in the direction of the obstacle as soon as they are airborne in order to get their boards across the obstacle. But this will cause the board to move out from under the center of gravity, making it impossible to land back on it. So, instead of immediately pushing the front foot toward the obstacle after popping, put it closer to the center of gravity first and keep your board under the center of gravity the whole time. And don't worry if your ollie becomes rocketed, you can get used to the feeling of leveling the board later. With these points in mind, you should be able to ollie over obstacles. And that's all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time.